Our today's discussion is on MATLAB simulation of closed-loop battery charge controller using phase-shifted full-bridge DC-DC converter. First, I will give you the specifications of the complete system. Input voltage is 400 volt. Switching frequency is 50 kHz. Transformer turn ratio is 400/70. Value of inductance is 40 microhenry. Value of capacitance is 200 microfarad. Battery nominal voltage is 48 volt. Maximum battery voltage is 55 volt. Battery capacity is 150 Ah. Maximum battery charging current is 25% of battery capacity. That is 37.5 ampere. This is the complete block diagram of the closed loop system that we are going to simulate now. Here we have both voltage control loop and current control loop. Vref is the maximum battery voltage, that is 55 volt. A limiter is provided at the output of the voltage controller to limit the battery charging current to its maximum value, that is 37.5 ampere. A limiter is also provided at the output of the current controller to limit the maximum PWM phase shift to 180 degree. Now we open the MATLAB and start doing the simulation. First, add a DC voltage source. Now add a MOSFET, and form the edge bridge. Now add a front block and connect it to the gate terminal of each MOSFET. Name the block PWM1. Name this block PWM2. Name this block PWM3. And name this block PWM4. Now add a linear transformer. Set the transformer parameters. Rated power is 2 kW and the operating frequency is 50 kHz. Set the primary voltage 400 and secondary voltage 70. Other resistance and inductance values you can keep very small figures, since I am considering an ideal transformer. Now add a diode and form the rectifier bridge. Add a series RLC branch. This is the filter inductor and set its value 40 microhenry. This is the filter capacitor and set its value 200 microfarad. Now add a current measurement block. This block is used to measure the battery current. Now add the battery. Flip this block left-right to make the connection easier. Now set the battery parameters. I'm using a 48 volt, 150 Ah lead acid battery with 50% SOC. Now add a bus selector. Add battery voltage, current and SOC into the bus. Add a go-to block. Name it as IBAT. Name this one, VBAT. Name this one, SOC. Name this one, IBAT1. We are actually using this current in the closed loop controller. Now we start building the controller blocks. First add a constant block. Set the reference voltage 55. Add a sum block. Change the signs to plus minus. Add a PID controller. Set its KP and KI values. Add a saturation block. Set the upper limit 37.5 and lower limit 0. Here 37.5 is the maximum charging current of the battery. Add another sum block. Connect the battery current to this block. Use the same PI controller for current also. Keep the upper limit of saturation block 180 degree, which is the maximum possible phase shift for the PSFB converter. This is the PWM generation block, which I have already explained in my previous video on the phase shifted full bridge converter. So you can watch that video to understand more about it. I will leave the link in the description. This is the set of code, which is used to generate the PWM signals. Now connect the output of the controller to this block. Here set the switching frequency, which is 50 kHz. Now add a clock. Add a logical operator. Make the operator type NOT. Now connect all the PWM signals to the gate terminal of MOSFET. Now add a display block. Add a scope. Connect battery voltage and current to the display and scope. Now open configuration parameter settings. Set solver type AUDI 23T. Set simulation time 5 seconds. Add a power guide block. Set simulation type discrete and sampling time 1e rise to minus 7. Add a voltage measurement block. Add a scope to view the transformer primary voltage. I forgot to set the DC input voltage. So set the voltage 400. Now run the simulation. Here you can see the battery voltage and current values. You can clearly see that the battery voltage is increasing as we keep charging the battery. This is the battery voltage and current waveforms. This is the transformer primary voltage. Now I will change the battery SOC level and run the simulation again. Here you can see that, since we increased the SOC, the battery voltage has also increased. This is the corresponding battery voltage and current. This is the transformer primary voltage. Now I will show you how the current starts decreasing as we increase the voltage. For that, first we need to change the SOC to 99%. Now run the simulation. You can closely observe the variations in the current. You can clearly see that the value of current has now come down. This is the corresponding battery voltage and current. And this is the transformer primary voltage. So this is the end of this presentation. Thanks for watching.